got my new structure scan set up here. These transducer arms here need to set up in place before I head out. Got two different transducer. This is the standard one, and this one is for the structure scan. I'm using the torpedo motor in conjunction with my paddling to go even faster. Underneath me. Come here, you. Okay. That's a better one. Depth finders and this structure scan is a great way to get the lay of the land, but as soon as I understand what's going on out here, I shut it off. What I'm really seeing, I can actually see on the surface. You can't always, but I can today. And that's really these foam bubbles. And there's a collection of them in a lane running right out here and back in that direction. And I zigzagged across it, and I can tell that I got some sort of structure right out here, whether it's a pipe or an oyster reef or there's something out here. And the current is rolling this way, and these foam bubbles, this calm water on the down current end of it, it's actually the north side right now, is where I'm marking fish, and it's also where these foam bubbles are. So I don't really need the depth finder right now, because I know what I've seen, and I know they're here. I came ashore to show you the new Lowrance HDS-7 with structure scan. I got the combo, got them bundled, so I could have both. The head unit here, I put into the slide track system. Just got some hardware there. It helps mount that right where I need it, right at my fingertips. I put in an order with Hook One to get these two transducer mounts. I got one on this side, one on the other. I have two, and this one's actually the structure scan, this long one. It shoots a signal out to both sides. And that signal actually goes to this box here. And that gives us the, the view of everything out to the side. The other one just goes straight down. I got my batteries mounted here together. I actually decided to use one battery for each. And just to keep them from sliding down underneath the seat there, I bundled them together with this big pool noodle. So let's go ahead and get it out on the water. Maybe scan the Bay Bridge pilings, see what they look like on the structure scan. Card for, here, get off this pile, and on the right side is the structure scan. I think it's already, let's see if it's picking up the big old pole to the left of me. I think I gotta be going at speed for it to really register well. We got two pilings here in front of me. Let's see if I can get them to show up here on structure scan. I'm gonna hit it at speed so it makes sense. Crank up the torquedo here. Looks like I had some fish over here on the lake. Shows how deep it is. So if it's if you were to hit a trench in there, it goes straight and then bump out and then go down. But as it were, we just have the those two bridge pilings right there. I think it's something that's going to take a while to figure out. You know, to kind of get an eye for what you're looking at. Just like when I got, you know, my first depth finder for the first time. Now, I don't need structure scan to tell me there's some bridge pilings off to the right and left of me, but I think where it's really going to pay off is those rock piles that are kind of out in the middle of nowhere. As you're just cruising from spot to spot, rip to rip, you're going to look left or right and say, wait, there's something out there. Let's go put a jig on it. Stuff that you just wouldn't know is there otherwise. Oh. This one isn't bad, but I lost one that was huge. I mean, just, I could do nothing with it. It just kept going and going and going. This one followed it up from the bottom behind one of the pilings. And the one that I missed was on the side that had all the current slamming into it. Which is contrary to how I caught them last time on the pilings. It's sort of interesting to me that, you know, it's a lot like smallmouth in the river. The big ones position on the upstream side of things in the summer. When it's hot, it's like they cool off with it. They like a little breeze. Behind the bridge piling. I want to pull him away from it. I gotta back up. I want him near the pilings. That's a good one. Beautiful fishies. They're starting to turn on again. It was exciting this morning and then it slacked off. And you know, they're starting to pick up again. That's a 19 and a half. Just had an 18. Getting some good fish again. It's all about that current, I think. You know, I stopped paddling for a second and now I'm pretty far away from the bridge piling. And when that current gets up, they eat. When it's slack tide, it's tough. I don't know, I probably went the middle 4 hours that I've been here, only catching two. As soon as I got here, I had seven, like one right after another, it seemed. And now I've just gotten three or four hits in a pretty short period of time. So they're turning on again.